My name is Bikki Vera, and I'm in the band Couscous, and you're watching Bobby Me.
Welcome back to Latvia. Yesterday you had a show in Tallinn. How was it? How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling really good. We had a long drive, but yesterday was perfect, you know. After we finished, the crowd couldn't stop screaming for more, but you know, it was a really good party. They were a little bit more reserved, but they were not.
Let's see how Latvians will be tonight, yeah.
It's been going good, you know, so far after we released the new album and the tour in the spring and the summer and the tour now, it's been going good. The new songs fit well into the program and people are pleased, so it's good.
An album Lies Are More Flexible. So what's the story behind it and what inspired you to write it, Lies?
Well, musically it was there have been a little bit of changes in the band. Stebbi quit and then Högni basically could not tour anymore. So me and Daniel decided that okay, now we're gonna do the next album, you know, go deeper into what pleases us. And there was this track on the Mexico album called Sustain that we loved very much. And for me, it was one of the identities on that album. And that track is very new wavy, new kind of rough electronic with inspired by the very early new wave in UK in the early 80s, 79, 80, 81. And it's slower grooves than than most of our songs. So we want a little bit to go a little bit slower and being a little bit inspired by that time in music and especially around chord structures and arpeggios. To be inspired by that time is. It's really interesting because it's the chord structures and approach to music is quite different than it is now. It was very post-punk attitude and people were doing strange things and getting away with it. Now it feels that everything needs to be smooth, but you know, I'm not.
And you mentioned the changes in band members. If I'm right, you're the one who is there from the beginning till now.
Yeah, and Daniel as well. We've been in the band from the beginning. Daniel and Siki founded the band, and Siki was a film director, and Daniel was this famous pop singer in Iceland. And after they decided that they wanted to make a band, they had these people who were all singers and musicians, but Daniel wanted to go electronic. And I was dragged into this band due to that. So the first album was more or less produced by me, Daniel, and my friend who was in an electronic band called T-World at that time, Maggie Leko, who quit in 2006. So it's been kind of, you know, me and Daniel have been the backbone of the band since the beginning. If you take away the part where Daniel left for two albums when we had Earth do the lead vocals on Attention and the album Forever.
Imagine it's 15 minutes to the show and you have to step on the stage. What do you usually do? Are there any rituals before the show?
Just go to the toilet and have a Campari. It's really simple.
That's it. And how would you describe the feeling when you're on the stage and you see the whole crowd in front of you, people dancing?
It's really good. You know, for me, you know, I've always loved partying and being in this position, just, you know, bringing the party on. It's really pleasing and the way that the music is done live, it's pretty, really much live arranged. So everything that comes, all the elements that comes in, go out, how everything is filtered and sculptured and how all the effects are, everything is made on the spot. So I can always play a little bit with the crowd and tease them and I do it differently each evening And then how me and Daniel interact on the stage is always something new and interesting happening. You know, I'd maybe just start with an intro and then, you know, then I wink him to start when I feel it's time to start doing the verses, and then he starts and then I follow him and we go into the chorus and then I break down, he does some ad-lib and then I follow him. So it's all about, it's so much about interaction on stage between us and doing that with you know, with a crowd going wild is of course, you know, amazing.
If you could change one thing in the world, what would it be?
Trim a little bit down this violent masculinity. Oof. You know, it's we really have come to a society where we have to trim down the violence, because, you know, we should be better than that.